Hi, my name is Felix, and today we will see how to create a map of any region of the world using the R programming language. So in this specific video, we'll see how to visualize Europe, but you can use this code to visualize any countries in Africa, in Asia, in America, really where you want. We will begin by downloading some data from the World Bank, plot this data in a world map, and then we'll see how to zoom on a specific region. So we'll see how to do that on Europe. And finally, we also see how you can adjust the color palette to take care of the distribution of your own data so the colors are well reported in your map. You can get all the code of this tutorial by joining my newsletter on felixanalytics.com. And once you subscribe, you will receive an automatic email from me with the URL of my GitHub account where you can download all the code. That being said, let's get started. So now we are in RStudio. So the first thing you want to do is to install the necessary R packages for this little project. And we will load the Tidyverse, which is a collection of packages for data wrangling and data visualization. The R Natural Earth R package, which allows us to download world data from the Natural Earth project. The library SF to work with simple features in R. And the library WBStats for the World Bank API. So now we want to download world data using the R Natural Earth package. And we will use NE underscore countries function. We scale as medium because we don't need detailed geographic data. And the return class will be SF because we want SF object to work with the SF package. So SF is once again simple features. And using the filter function from the applier, we will directly remove Antarctica from our data. So I will run these two lines of code. Now I want to also change the world map projection, which can be done very easily using the st underscore transform function, also from the SF package. And here I decided to use the molvide projection. So that's the way you will specify you want to use this kind of projection. So now I want to get some data to play with. So we will download a random indicator from the World Bank using the World Bank API. So here I decided to visualize unemployment as percent of the labor force. This is a unique way to identify this indicator. And using the WB underscore cached list dataset that will be automatically loaded in your own global environment when you load the WB stats package, you can have a list of all the indicators available. And here we will filter. So again, using the same filter function from the applier, keep only the indicator we are interested in to get information about it. To download this specific indicator, it's easy. You just use a WB underscore data function from this WB stats package. You put the indicator unique identifier and you can choose, for example, here the start date. So I choose 2020 and I decided to keep only this date for our tutorial. So if you want to have a glimpse of the dataset, you can use the glimpse function. On here we see we have a dataset of 9 columns on 217 rows with the ISO code. So these are unique identifier for each country of 2 letters for ISO 2 code on ISO 3 codes. As you can see, it's 3 letters for each country. So Aruba, Afghanistan, etc. We have the date here, the percentage of our indicator, missing values for the unique, the observation status, a footnote, and we also have a last update. As a very quick data exploratory analysis, we will see the distribution of our indicator. So here I will just plot an histogram using ggplot2. And as you can see here, we have our data that is strongly concentrated around 5-6% of unemployment. This can be a bit annoying because we will hardly see the difference in the color palette for these specific percentages. So if we use a square root transformation on our percentage for the color palette, you will see that we have a more normally distributed distribution over here. So this could help to better see the differences in the colors. So we'll see that a bit later. So we'll take our world object with the molvide transformation, which is over here, and we will left join our data that we just downloaded from the World Bank. here is just a data example. And the idea, of course, is to use your own data with it. And I would encourage you to use the ISO 3 code or ISO 2 codes to join when you have country names, because in the two different data sets that you have, you may have the country name that are written differently, but with the ISO codes, you are sure you are joining the countries together. So if I do that, as you can see, we have our geometry data from our SF object. And here you can see our indicator from the World Bank that we have over here with the different percentages for each country. Now, once again, we will use the ggplot to visualize our data. And we will use the geometry germ underscore SF with fill with the name of our indicator. And using this, we can have a first look at our world map. So here we are happy. We have our MOLE-VIDE transformation that looks good, but two things we want to change now, the color palette and again, the data distribution that is very concentrated in this dark blue area. So using the square root transformation, we will be able to see more clearly the differences in this area. So you can do that using the scale fill viridis C function. So viridis is the name of the color palette and C stands for continuous because we have continuous data set by opposition with discrete variable that are categories. The transformation we want to do is to use the square root. So it's using the trans argument. The label we will use percent format because they are percentages with a scale of 1 and we will use a break to improve the labeling of our legend because we use the square root on our percentages. So let's run this code so you have a look on how it looks like. So now we can see this nice color palette from blue to yellow. So let me zoom on this so you can see it better. And we can see more clearly here the differences that are in the dark blue, in particular here, European countries, for example, if you want to zoom on this. And that we will do a bit later in this tutorial. Now you can notice that we have a digital bug over here. We don't see the degree. I don't know if you will have that also in your own computer, but I had that. So I looked on Stack Overflow and I saw we can use this little two lines of code to fix this problem. I will add also a background as blue because it looks nicer, I think. And we can add the title based on our indicator information and a caption also using these two information we downloaded from the World Bank API. So let's run now our full code. And if I zoom over here, we can see our world map. Now, let's say that you want to zoom on one area of this map, for example, Europe, but you can choose any area of the world over here. I will show you how to do that. To choose the area, you will need to know the coordinates of what is called a bounding box. So it's just the area you want to zoom on your world map. And I found out that OpenStreetMap have a nice tool to do that. So let's have a look at this, but there are plenty of other websites that allows you to get these coordinates. So let's have a look at it. So now we are in OpenStreetMap in my browser and we can select any region of the world. So you just can click over here and manually select a different area. And here you have a bounding box and let's say you want to use it to visualize Europe. And when you do this, you will see different numbers here, which are equivalent to latitude and longitude. And this can be transposed in the code that I showed you. So now back to RStudio, we can just transpose all these numbers into the little code that I have here. So I would just take these numbers over here from the left. So we will replace this number over here. So now we need the bottom over here, the right, on the top. So if you run this code, we will have the window coordinates over here as an SF object. We should not forget to transform again these coordinates with our MOLE-VIDE projection. And here the ST underscore coordinates will allow us to retrieve these specific coordinates from this projection. Now the final move is to add a new line, a new function in our previous code for the world map, just to have a zoom on this specific area. And to do that, we will use a chord underscore SF function here. And for the X limits, We will use the X on here, the Y limb, and we will select the Y. So let's run all this code again and see how it looks like. So maybe here we have too much ocean, so let's change that a bit. Let's change it to 18 over here. And feel free just to experiment. So I don't know, this is just for the tutorial. Let's say that we are happy with that and we want to improve a bit our visualization. One thing we want to do is to remove maybe the African countries over here, because we may be only interested in European countries, and remove also here Greenland. The other thing you may want to change is the scale. Here maybe the story you want to tell is the comparison of percent unemployment amongst European countries. And for that we want to have our extreme yellow and dark blue values are the highest and lowest percentage of the European countries. And here maybe the distribution will not be skewed as it was for our global data on unemployment. Maybe also you may think that using a transformation on your scale can be misleading for your audience. So we will remove this transformation and we will only create the color scale based on our European country. So to do that again, so we will just filter the data with the only European countries, and we will remove the transformation and the breaks over here. And the rest will be exactly the same. So let's run this code now. And here, as you can see, the North African and Greenland disappeared. Our color palette with the scale is different. We see the Baltic countries and Spain that is popping up, and North countries in dark blue. So here you see you have in some ways a different story, a different way to show you data to compare to our other plot over here. Let's run it again. We see that, but here is more like a comparison with global data on unemployment, and the other one is more like a comparison between countries. So be careful about how you use the colors and how you use the scale when you create visualizations using R. Well, I hope you found this video useful. If you did, consider subscribing or giving me a like. If you want to get the code of this tutorial, you can join my newsletter on felixanalytics.com, and I see you in another video. Take care. Bye bye.